Dear students, now we are discussing on the electrical transformer. What is transformer? Transformer is a static AC device which is used to change the high voltage low level current into low level high current AC and vice versa without changing the frequency. Basically, transformer is a it transfers electrical power from one circuit to another. It does so without change of frequency. It accomplishes this by electromagnetic induction, where the two electric circuits are in mutual inductive influence of each other. Now, principle of operation. Basically, transformer principle is based on principle of mutual induction, according to which an EMF is induced in a coil when current in the neighboring coil changes. Now, the types of transformer. Transformers are classified based on their construction, utility, duty, etc. Some of them are power and distribution transformer. Basically, power transformers are used in power plants and distribution transformers are in the different utilities. These are used for the power supplies. Power transformers used in generating substations, main power plants at each end of transmission line for a step up or a step down voltage, and this particular transformer is called the power transformer. For a distribution transformer, these types of transformers used to step down the distribution voltage to service voltage or transmission voltage to distribution voltage is called the distribution transformers. Now, the instrument transformers. These are used for measurement, control and for protection purposes. Basically, in these instrument transformers, we are discussing on VT and PT, that is potential transformer, which are used for voltage measurement, and CT, that is current transformer, which is used for measuring the current. Now, the transformer construction. The simplest element of a transformer consists of two coils having mutual inductance and a laminated steel core. The two coils are insulated from each other and the steel core. Basically, steel core, it is CRGO, cold rolled grain oriented material core. Core is made up of thin laminations of high grade silicon steel. It is the backbone of the transformer. From magnetic and mechanical strength aspects, windings are wound concentrically around the core limb. Different types of windings are used, such as cylindrical, helical, crossover, disc type, and used for depending on the voltage and kVA rating of the transformer. It is the most sensitive part, subjected to thermal, mechanical and dielectric stresses. The core and winding are enclosed in a tank made for MS sheet. The tank is filled with transformer oil as a dielectric medium. Now, we are discussing on the accessories, different accessories which are for the transformers. These are mounted on a transformer for protection and monitoring purpose. First is conservator. The oil level in transformer change with change in temperature of oil, which in turn depends on load and ambient temperature. The oil expand if temperature increases and contracts if temperature decreases. Conservator is a large cylinder connected by a pipe to transformer to take care of oil level in main tank during expansion and contraction of the oil. Now, the silica breather. When oil in transformer expands, air is expelled out, and when it contracts, air is drawn in. This is called basically the breathing of the transformer. The air entering in the transformer passes via an apparatus called breather. It consists of a container filled with dry silica gel crystals and oil seal assembly at the lower end of the container filled with oil. Silica gel absorbs moisture from the incoming air during the contraction. Oil acts as a coarse filter and removes dust from the air Silica gel is blue in color when dry and become pink when wet. Now the Buchholz relay. As we know, relay is sensing element used for the protection purpose. It is the gas and oil operated device used for protecting the transformer from incipient faults, that means internal faults, and during the short circuits inside the transformer. This is mounted between conservator and main tank. The device is having two floats. One activates and give alarm in case of incipient internal faults, generating a small amount of gas. Other operates the trip the transformer in case of major faults, which results in high pressure and surge in oil flow. Now the magnetic level gauge, in short it is called the MOG. Basically, this is a dial type level indicating device provided on a large transformers with conservator at relatively high level. It is provided with low oil contacts to give an alarm when oil level in conservator falls to a low level. Now temperature indicator, that is OTI and WTI. OTI stands for oil temperature indicator and WTI stands for winding temperature indicator. Temperature of oil and winding defines the life and performance of the transformers. High temperature of oil winding can be due to overloading, improper cooling. High temperature of oil and winding reduces life of transformer oil and windings. OTI, that is oil temperature indicator, and WTI, winding temperature indicators, are used for monitoring and protection of the transformer against the high temperatures. Typical setting for alarm and trip circuit are as follows. Basically, these parameters are taken from the actual working in industries for the transformer temperature protection. OTI, the alarm is set on 80 degree centigrade and trip if temperature rises to 90 degree centigrade. This means as long as the temperature is below 80 degree, it is working temperature, but as the temperature comes to 80 or more, the alarm is giving the information that there is some abnormal performance is going on. Still, this temperature is increases to the 90 degree, there a transformer has to be tripped, that is stop working. Same for WTI, if 85 degree centigrade comes, alarm will come. If temperature rises to 95 degree, there is a trip for the transformer. Now the pressure relief valve, PRV, or explosion vent. A major fault inside the transformer causes instantaneous vaporization of oil, leading to rapid buildup of gases pressure. If pressure is not relieved, transformer tank can rupture or explode. A PRV is a protective device which provides instantaneous relief of gaseous pressure. Valve is mounted on the tank over above an opening. It consists of SS diaphragm, which can be lifted above when pressure inside tank increases and returned to original position when pressure drops down to normal value. Lifted diaphragm can be used to actuate limit switch to trip the transformer. Now the radiator. The function of radiator is to limit the temperature of oil and winding by heat dissipation that is generated by losses within the transformer while in service. The number of sections per radiator and the number of radiators depend upon the losses and permissible temperature rise. Cooling of transformer. As the transformer is long in operation, there is a generation of heat, so cooling is necessary. The transformer is a static device which converts energy at one voltage level to another voltage level. During the process of energy transformation, losses occurs in winding and core of the transformer. These losses appears as heat. The heat developed in the transformer is dissipated to surrounding. The cooling of transformer helps in maintaining the temperature rise in various parts of transformer within permissible limit. There are various methods are available for cooling of transformers depending upon size and type of transformers. The type of cooling is identified by standard designation. First, medium of cooling used as air shown by capital A, gas shown by capital G, synthetic oil shown by L, mineral oil shown by O, solid insulators shown by S, and water cooling is shown by W. There are different types of circulation used, which are natural and forced. Natural is shown by N and forced is shown by F. Now we are going to discuss the various types of cooling used for trial for oil immersed transformer are as follows. ONAN, that means oil natural, air natural. ONAF, that is oil natural, air forced. OFAN, that is oil forced, air natural. OFAF, oil forced, air forced. ONWN, oil natural, water natural. OFWF, oil forced, water forced. Majorly transformers are power transformers, ONAF, ONAF. That means they are provided oil natural, air natural, and oil natural, air forced cooling. For distribution transformer, it is ONAN, that oil natural, air natural. Now the transformer oil, one of the most important factor which determines the satisfactory operation of transformer is the oil in which it is immersed. Transformer oil provides insulation and cooling. Transformer oil is a mineral oil, clean hydrocarbon oil obtained by refining crude petroleum. Some of important characteristics necessary in the transformer oil are as follows. Now we are discussing with respect to characteristics and limit value as per Indian standards 335. Electrical strength should be minimum 45 kV, flash point maximum 140 degree centigrade, acidity neutralization value 0.03 milligram KOH per gram, resistivity at 27 degree centigrade minimum 500 into 10 raised to power 2 ohm centimeter. Water content in ppm is not to be max to 10. Density at 27 degree centigrade 0.89 gram per centimeter cube. Now we are discussing on the voltage control and tap changers. It is very essential to maintain the system voltage within a prescribed limit for better health of electrical equipments. The device tap changer is used for adding or cutting out of turns of primary winding or secondary winding of the transformer for getting required output voltage. The tappings are located on high voltage winding because smaller current to be dealt with. Basically, tap changing equipments can be divided into categories. OCTC, that is off circuit tap changers, and OLTC, that is on load tap changers. What do you mean by OCTC? It is mainly used for where tap changes required is not very frequent. It is essential to de-energize the transformer before changing the tape. De-energizing, that means it is a off circuit working. OLTC, that means on load tap changer. It is employed to change the turn ratio of transformer to the regulated system voltage while the transformer is delivering the load. The OLTC can be operated in auto or a manual mode from local or remote location. In manual mode, tapes are changed as when required, whereas in auto mode, a voltage regulating relay is used, which gives command on voltage changes depending on set voltage. Now we come to the point, maintenance and condition monitoring of the transformer. Because transformer is working for a continuously for 24 hours, that is whole day, so it is very important to discuss the maintenance and conditioning monitoring of the transformer. There are the different shift through which we are going to inspect the transformer. So in the first column we are giving the inspection frequency, second items to be inspected, third inspection notes, what actually we are inspecting. After this inspection, what action we do for the if unsatisfactory conditions are to be there. As example, in shift we are taking care of ambient temperature, winding temperature, oil temperature, load, amperes, voltage. What are the different inspection notes for these particular items? Such as winding temperature, that means we check the temperature rise. Load amperes, that is check against the load. Voltage, that means whether it is secondary voltage is up to the rated value or not. If that particular values are not as per the design value, then what actions we are do. Such for a winding temperature, we shut down the transformer and investigate if either what is the basic problems. Oil temperature, if it is higher to the design value, we are going to shut down the transformer or given the protection to the transformer. For a daily inspection, we are going to take care oil level, dehydrating breather and explosion vent. For half yearly maintenance, we are taking care of bushings, oil in tap changers, oil in transformers tank. What the inspection notes? Examine for cracks, dirt deposits, check for dielectric strength. If that it they are not in proper condition, what actual action required? That is clean or replace the bushing. For oil in transformer is low, take proper action to restore a quality of oil. In yearly maintenance, what we are doing, we are checking the insulation resistance, gasket joints, and if they are not proper, we are going to check cleanliness, soundness of the bushing, tighten bolt, so that work transformer should be work in a normal condition. In yearly, these points are also taken care: cable boxes, relay alarms, temperature indicators, earth resistance and paint work. Now in this particular slide, we are seeing the specifications of the transformer. There's different ratings of the transformer. In a transformer, we are taking care of the rating, voltage level, that is for high voltage winding, low voltage winding, current for high voltage, for low voltage, frequency. In India it is a 50 hertz, for vector group, for percentage impedance, tapping of for the voltage control, tap changers with whether it is a offline or a online, maximum ambient temperature, maximum temperature rise of oil, winding temperature and total oil quantity. Now the point come protection of the transformer. The faults occurring in transformers are different, but we can give a specific name such as earth fault, phase to phase faults, interturn faults, overheating, etc. The choice of protection of any transformer depends upon the size and importance, etc. Following type of protection provided for various abnormal conditions. For a specifically for a power transformer, that means that this particular power transformer are situated in a power plants for voltage rise. These are the different protections are used for the power transformer. Buchholz relay. Buchholz relay is used for incipients and large internal faults below oil level. That means if oil level come below to the standard level or a defined level, then this particular protection is provided. Temperature indicators used for overheating or oil or winding temperature. For a differential protection, these are used to protect from face-to-face and face-to-earth faults. Then overcurrent relay for overcurrent and short circuit, horn gaps and lighting arresters for high voltage surges, and for overvoltage relay used for saturation of magnetic circuit. So basically these are the different protections which are used for the power transformer. I think we are already discussed the basic principle of operation, working of transformers, different auxiliaries, accessories, and protection of the transformer. This all about the for the lecture 1. Thank you.